Hi students, today we will revise chapter 4. Okay, so everyone get ready with the book. Revision of the chapter we will do today. This is the chapter that we are doing. In this chapter we will learn about identify and the use of different special keys. What are the uses of certain keys in combination? That means two keys together, what does it work? How does it work? We will learn. Describe the function of different types of keys. We will learn. So, let us start now. First, there is one get going in page 28. The keyboard is shown to you and certain keys are given some outline. You have to write the names of those keys over here with pencil and color those keys using the color that is shown in the outline box. I think the work is very easy and you can do it on your own. Okay, so now let us start the chapter. Now, we have already learned that keyboard is used for typing. And it has many keys which are used to type words, numbers, symbols, etc. It is used to give input to the computer. And a normal keyboard usually has 104 keys. Apart from the alphabet and the numeric keys, there has many special keys. In this chapter, we will learn about those special keys. But earlier, we have already learnt about the delete key, enter key and the spacebar key in class 1. Now, we will learn along with these special keys, some other keys, special keys too. Let us start. Please turn the page. Now, alphabet keys and numeric keys we will learn today. What are the alphabet keys? A to Z that are written in the keyboard are called the alphabet keys. There are 26 such keys. As 26 alphabets are there, so 26 alphabet keys are also there. Now, we can type words and sentences using these alphabet keys. The first six letters in the top row, that is Q, W, E, R, T, Y. This forms the word QWERTY. And for these six letters, we call this keyboard as QWERTY keyboard. Clear everyone? Next, numeric keys or numlock key. There we have 0 to 9 written. 10 in number. Numeric keys are 10 in number, 0 to 9. These are found in two places, above the alphabet key and also on the right side of the keyboard. Two sets of numeric keys are there. The number key on the right hand side, this one, are called as numeric keypad. To use the numeric keypad, this num lock should be on. When it is on, you can see a green light. This one, this numlock, this green light is on. And when it is off, this numlock is off. So, when this numlock is on, that time only we can use these numbers. When this numlock is off, that time we cannot use this numeric keypad. Only we can use this numeric keypad. This one is called the enter key. Enter key is found in two places. It is to take the cursor to the next line. Cursor means cursor is the blinking line on the monitor where we can type. So whenever we need to use the next line, we use the enter key. This is called the spacebar, the longest key on the keyboard. And this spacebar is used to give space between two words. These are the arrow keys, up, down, left and right. These keys are used to move the cursor in the fourth direction. These arrow keys are also called the cursor control keys. Delete key. It deletes the character from right of the cursor. It is found in two places. Backspace key. This one, it deletes the character from the left hand side of the cursor. In the keyboard, this one is the enter key. Everyone can see it. This is one enter key, this is another enter key. This one is the backspace key. This one is the delete key. Then we have the space bar over here. These are the arrow keys, up, down, left and right. Okay, so these are the different keys that we are learning today. Space bar is used to give the space between two words. Enter key is used to give right in the next line. Delete key is used to delete a character from the right of the cursor. Backspace key is used to delete the character from the left of the cursor. And arrow keys are used to move the cursor in the four direction. Now, caps lock key. These are the caps lock key. See in the keyboard, this is the caps lock key. Now, caps lock key is on. The letters that we type will appear in capital. We can see a green light above the numeric keypad. That means the caps lock key is on. If this light is off, that means the caps lock key is not on and the typing will all be in small letters. Next, shift key. This one is the shift key, and in the computer, this one is one shift key and we have another shift key here. Okay, this is one shift key and this one is another shift key. Clear everyone? Next, there are two shift keys. This key is used along with the other keys. Some keys have two characters on them, especially the punctuation marks and the special symbols are marked on the upper side of the keys. To type any of this symbol, we must press the shift key along with the other key. See, some of the special keys are there with the numbers. You can see it. The punctuation marks, two symbols are there in one key. So how to use these upper symbols? Using the shift key pressed, if you press this key along with the shift key, that means this punctuation, upper punctuation mark will be used. Clear everyone? Next, shift key is also used to type the letters in capital. That means whenever we type M, if the caps lock key is off, if we press the shift key with the M key, and it will be in the capital letter. Quick byte. To type only a few letters in capital, press the shift key with that letters. Now there is one flash test. What will you get when you type the following? Shift plus 4. You will get this sign dollar. Shift plus 2. You will get this sign at the rate. When caps lock key is on, this will give this, and shift plus K will give small letter K. The tab key is used to move the cursor right by 5 spaces at a time. This is the tab key. This is the tab key. So if we press this tab key, the cursor will be moved 5 spaces at a time. Escape key. This one is the escape key. Escape key is found on the top left corner of the keyboard. It is used to cancel or close a menu. For example, if we have clicked on the start button, you will click on escape to close the menu. Clear? To cancel or close any menu, we use the escape key. The QWERTY keyboard was created by Christopher Solers in 1868. Now, today's HW will be to write this let's recap in the computer CW copy. As we have done the revision work today, revision of the chapter, so now it's your turn to read the chapter thoroughly and after that write the let's recap of this chapter in the computer CW copy and send me the work at dphahelpdesk@gmail.com for correction. So everyone, stay at home, stay healthy, finish your work, don't forget if you send it to me, and bye bye.